Costa Rica is birdy. Over 900 species of birds have been recorded in a country roughly the size of Bosnia and Herzegovina. In few other groups does this species richness become as apparent as it is in the hummingbirds. This microcosm of microbirds fascinates many bird lovers, from beginners to experts. There are well over 300 species of hummingbirds in the world, and while they only occur in the Americas, they inhabit a wide array of habitats, from deserts to dense forests, from coastal mangroves to highland shrubs near the highest peaks. And this small country, nestled between North America and South America, between the Pacific Ocean and the Caribbean Sea, hosts over 50 of these beautiful birds. That is roughly 15% of all hummingbird species in the world. And that is crazy. Now, while you'd be hard-pressed to find anyone who doesn't love hummingbirds, they can be quite challenging to identify. Field guides paint colorful pictures, and in ideal conditions, the iridescent feathers of several species can indeed be absolutely spectacular. More often than not, though, observations aren't ideal. Sometimes it's because of the bird's behavior. Hummingbirds are small and restless. Some like to feed high up in the canopy, offering only painfully short glimpses at their field marks. Sometimes it's because of external factors. Light conditions in cloud and rainforests can be pretty tough even on nice days, and rainy days seem to suck the color right out of the birds. But mostly it's because of the birds themselves. Hummingbird feathers differ from the feathers of many other species. Their shining colors aren't created by pigments, but rather by tiny structures on their feathers that act like a prism. Recent studies have shown that hummingbirds are significantly more colorful than any other group of birds, especially taking into account ultraviolet colors. Take a look at the Talamanca hummingbird. Here it is in the Dean and Gallagher's field guide, where it is still known as Magnificent Hummingbird, of which it used to be considered a subspecies. It's a fantastic drawing by Robert Dean, highlighting the colorful throat and the iridescent crown. Let's look at a bird I photographed a couple of years ago in the Dota region of Costa Rica. No doubt, Talamanca hummingbird. Couldn't be clearer from the field guide. Except, here's the same bird, photographed just a few seconds earlier, before I took a couple of steps to the left. Sure, still identifiable as a Talamanca hummingbird, but it doesn't quite look like the illustration anymore. That's part of the trouble with these birds. In this ID series, we're going to take a look at the hummingbirds that regularly occur in Costa Rica, where to find them and how to identify them. In later videos, we'll group them by the habitats. But to get things started, we'll cover some of the hummingbirds that are very easy to distinguish from the others. Those with a curved bill. There are seven species that immediately stand out from the rest of Costa Rica's hummingbird. Their bill has an obvious curved shape. These are the violet sabrewing and the six hermit species. Bronzy hermit, band-tailed barbthroat, green hermit, stripe-throated hermit, long-billed hermit, and the white-tipped sicklebill. The hermits aren't called hermits because they're not sociable. Instead, the name refers to the drab plumage of most species. Most hermits don't show gender dimorphism, meaning that males and females look alike. Hermits are often associated with heliconia flowers, or wild plantains. In fact, their unique bill shape makes them important pollinators of these plants. The white-tipped sicklebill might just be the most unique of the bunch. It is the only hummingbird in Costa Rica with a streaked breast, which would be pretty cool already if the bill wasn't way cooler. The extreme curvation of the bill allows it to perch on heliconia flowers while feeding. A curious behavior and a fascinating example of coevolution of a flower and one of its main pollinators. The white-tipped sicklebill can be found in the Caribbean foothills and lowlands, between 300 and 700 meters, and in the South Pacific, between 1,000 and 1,200 meters. Costa Rica's largest hummingbird, the violet sabrewing, is actually not a hermit hummingbird. However, I've chosen to include it here due to the decurved bill. The male is truly striking, with glittering violet plumage and white outer tail feathers. The female is slightly less distinctive, but still very recognizable, with a violet throat. Violet sabrewings are quite common at middle elevations. You'll see them around the feeders in Monteverde or at Cinchona, where they aggressively defend their territories from other hummingbirds. The only slightly smaller green hermit is unique among the hermit hummingbirds in two ways. Its plumage isn't drab and brown, but rather a shining green. It's also the only hermit hummingbird species with gender dimorphism. The male is bluish green, with a darker eye mask that's barely visible. Its white central tail feathers protrude beyond the rest of the tail. The female is more distinctly patterned, the face mask is more obvious, and the pale underparts contrast with the bluish-green back. Its bill and central tail feathers are even longer than the male's. The green hermit is rather common in foothills and middle elevations. Our final large hummingbird, the long-billed hermit, essentially looks like a brown version of the female green hermit. The face mask is very pronounced, and the long white-tipped central tail feathers are distinctive. Unlike the green hermit, this species mainly inhabits the wet lowlands, where it forages in the lower levels of mature forest and second growth. Our final three species for today are about 5 centimeters smaller than the previous ones. And they do look somewhat similar. The striped-throated hermit, the bronzy hermit, and the band-tailed barb-throat. The striped-throated hermit almost looks like a miniature long-billed hermit. Despite its name, the stripes on the throat of the Costa Rican subspecies aren't terribly obvious. In fact, it's sometimes considered a separate species altogether. Its tail is more tapered than the one of the long-billed hermit, and it shows rufous tips. The central tail feathers are also comparatively shorter. The striped-throated hermit is common in wet lowlands and foothills, but it does also occur in drier areas, such as the North Pacific. The bronzy hermit is very similar in overall coloration, but note that it lacks the elongated central tail feathers. Its throat is a pale cinnamon orange, and the base of the outer tail feathers is reddish. The bronzy hermit is uncommon throughout its habitat, the wet lowlands, where it can be found foraging, especially in forest edge zones. Very similar, the band-tailed barb-throat is a slightly more common sight. Unlike the bronzy hermits, its outer tail feathers have a white base. The dark throat is also distinctive. Overall, the plumage is a bit more contrasting, the face mask more defined, and the orange chest more saturated. Costa Rica's hummingbirds are a fascinating world of incredibly specialized birds. In today's video, we met the hermits, a group of hummingbirds that has evolved in close relationship with its main food source, Heliconia flowers. We'll continue to see such coevolution in many other species, and things are also going to get a lot more colorful. Over the course of this series, we'll take a journey through Costa Rica's habitats and get to know all the hummingbirds you can reasonably hope to see in this beautiful country. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Ciao.